Good evening and welcome to our Eucharistic celebration. Today we celebrate Thursday of the Lord's Supper. Today Jesus, washing his disciples' feet, teaches vividly the meaning of love. Today Christ gives to the church the gift of the Eucharist and of the priestly order. Today the Lord accepts death that we might have life. All Mass intentions in Beata, Pro, and Formorum and Animus are scrolling live stream. They're also printed and posted within the main church and chapels. Additionally, they are in the sacristy for the priest to pray for at each Mass and are also placed on the altar during the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. Our presider for our Eucharist is Father Tom McGrath. Concelebrating is Monsignor James Beneventi and Father Will Mamangan. Assisting is Deacon Steve Martinez. Please stand and let us pray the Angelus and the Eucharistic Revival Prayer. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us
sinners now.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into your hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel, May his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be.
Glory be to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Glory be to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus Christ, you give us your flesh and blood for the life of the world, and you desire that all people come to the supper of the sacrifice of the Lamb. Renew in your church the truth, beauty, and goodness contained in the most blessed Eucharist. Jesus, living in the Eucharist, come and live in us. Jesus, healing in the Eucharist, come and heal us. Jesus, sacrificing yourself in the Eucharist, come and suffer in us. Jesus, rising in the Eucharist, come and rise to a new life in us. Jesus, loving in the Eucharist, come and love in us. Lord Jesus Christ, through the Paschal mystery of your death and resurrection, made present in every Holy Mass, pour out your healing love on your church and on our world. Grant that as we lift you up during the time of Eucharistic revival, your Holy Spirit may draw all the people to join us in this banquet of life. You live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Santa Maria in Camelin, Mother of the Eucharist, pray for us. Amen.
Our entrance song is number 144, Glory in the Cross, 144.
Let us ever glory in the cross of Christ, our salvation and our hope. Let us bow in homage to the Lord of life, who was broken to make us whole. There is no greater love, as blessed as this, to lay down one's life for a friend. Let us ever glory in the cross of Christ and the triumph of God's great love. Let us make our journey to the cross of Christ with surrendered glory and grace, to become a servant of the great and small, that all people may know God's face. Though his birth was divine, he knelt as a slave to wash common dust from our feet. Let us ever glory in the cross of Christ and the triumph of God's great love. Tell the story of the cross of Christ as we share this heavenly feast. We become one body in the blood of Christ, from the great to the very least. When we eat of this bread and drink of this cup, we honor the death of the Lord. Let us triumph of God's great love. Let us stand together at the cross of Christ, where we see God's boundless love. We are saints and sinners who are joined by faith here on earth.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
I confess to Almighty, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do.
Through my fault.
Through my fault, through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask, Holy angels and saints,
my brothers, pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son went about to hand himself over to death, entrusted on the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of the month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood, apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you should eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord, for on the same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, in which your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So, during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Experience has shown us that with words, you can do things. If the manager of a shop says you're fired, that has a great effect on you. You no longer belong to the company over which he has charged. If a major league umpire coming to third base, seeing the runner come in, says, "You're out," the flow of the game is interrupted immeasurably because of that. When we look at the account of creation, we see that God speaks a word and something happens. Let there be light, and there is light. Nothing pre-existing, it just happens because his word is eternal, his word is powerful. You may recall Jesus when he is in the Sea of Galilee, there is a great storm, the waves are high, and he stands up and he says, "Be still, peace." And all of a sudden, the wind stops, and there is great calm on the sea. It is almost like glass. You can look upon it. Such is the powerful word of Jesus. When Jesus went to visit his good friends, Martha and Mary, Lazarus had already been dead 4 days and buried. And he comes and he says, "Lazarus, come out." And Lazarus, with some of the accoutrements for the burial still on him, comes out and greets the Lord. Powerful word. You may recall also that there was a little girl who had fallen dead in her room. And Jesus came up to her and said, "Talita kum," "little girl, get up." She got up and walked around. Important events then when Jesus speaks. You recall too on the night of the Last Supper, Jesus said, taking the unleavened bread, "This is my body, which is given for you. Take it and eat it." In that instance, the bread became the body of Jesus. And then he said, "Drink from this cup, all of you. This is for the remission of sins." And he explained in those moments the key interpretive meaning of Calvary and the upper room. What had happened was people did not see what was happening, and it was quiet, so he could get the point across without difficulty. What was to happen was that Jesus's body would be broken and then tossed aside. His blood would be poured out in sacrifice for the forgiveness of sins. Therefore, Jesus fulfilled perfectly the will that his Father had asked him to work. We know now that Jesus is the one who lays down his life for us when he gives his body and blood for us. That is his gift to us. Finally, we come to say, what is the meaning of it all? And I think in the time that we spend in prayer and contemplation this evening, tomorrow, the true meaning of the Calvary experience on Good Friday will ring true. And we will see really what the Father asked of Jesus and the great willingness on the part of Jesus to fulfill it to the full.
During the washing of the feet, our hymn is number 146, As I Have Done For You, 146.
Where your joy will have no end.
Are you alone?
Jesus has promised us, whenever two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in their midst. Let us unite ourselves with Christ and make our prayers to the Father through him.
We pray for our archdiocese, that we be granted a shepherd who will lead us in being Christ's heart of mercy, voice of hope, and hands of justice. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the Church, that she may respond to the presence of Jesus in the Holy Eucharist with greater love and devotion. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who have come here tonight to celebrate this Mass of the Lord's Supper, that just as Christ has given himself to us in the Eucharist, we may learn to share our lives with others. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all the sick, and for Gilshin O'Hara, Juan B. Perez, that the peace and healing of the risen Christ may be theirs. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our deceased brothers and sisters, and for Rosario Flores Antolan, that they may live forever in the light of the risen Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all the prayers we now offer in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you have given us the body and blood of Christ, your Son, to nourish us on our journey through life. Give us your strength that we may truly be disciples and come at last to the banquet of eternal life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 325, Bread for the World, 325.
Divide your people, you are waiting there. Jesus Christ, who call us to your feast, at which the rich and powerful have become the least. Where we survival, others in our human greed, you walk among us, begging for your every need. Wherefore the
that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and of all.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, and whatever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. And as we eat this flesh that was sacrificed for us. We are made clean, we are made strong, and as we drink this blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so the angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Pope Francis, and all those who holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, Gilson and O'Hara, Juan B. Paris. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glories of our Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service and that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in peace, and command that we may be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock that you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it acceptable. Make it spiritual and acceptable, that it may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus, of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, He took the precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving thanks, said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, resurrection from the dead, and glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given to us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts may be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember, Lord, your servants Rosario Antolan and Paul Shimizu, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your protection. Through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, you fill them with life, you bless them, and you bestow them upon us. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done.
On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I unite myself to you as if you were already there. Keep me close to you each day. Amen.
Our hymn for communion is number 372, Bread of Angels, 372. Number 333, One Love Released, 333.
Oh,
grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so may we enjoy his banquet for eternity, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Our schedule for Good Friday is as follows. 1:30 p.m., Stations of the Cross, Rosary, Seven Last Words. 3 p.m., Celebration of the Lord's Passion, followed by procession. There will be a rosary for Rosario Charo Antolan at 6 p.m. in the Chapel of St. Therese. On Saturday, rosary for Rosario Charo Antolan will be at 6:30 p.m. in the Chapel of St. Therese, followed by Mass of Intentions at the Easter Vigil at 7 p.m. in the main church. Our Easter Sunday Masses on March 31st will be at 6 a.m. in English, 7:30 a.m., 9:30 a.m., and 11:30 a.m. All Masses will be in the main church. There will be no 6 p.m. Mass that day. There will be an Easter egg hunt after the 7:30 a.m. Mass on Easter Sunday for children 10 years old and under. Don't forget to bring your basket. Please help spread the word. Jesus Masi.
Lastly, we're going to have a short procession here down the aisle to the Chapel of St. Therese to bring the Blessed Sacrament to the altar of repose. The Chapel of St. Therese will be open until midnight for adoration. At 11:45 p.m., we're going to pray the Stations of the Cross and then close at midnight. Thank you.